David Navara scores a big win against Nils Grandelius and moves to 6.5 going into the penultimate round. He joins us in our studio in Gibraltar. David, a crucial win today in round 8. Give us your thoughts.
Okay, I was surprised by Nils' opening choice because I expected him to play rather e4, e5 as he often played it against stronger opponents, but probably he had chosen a different approach for this tournament because he had already played e4, e5 against Wesley Saw, who is very strong. And okay, I was sort of surprised, so I decided to surprise Nils in turn, and I played Sicilian with bishop a4, which is a rare but topical, okay, not topical, but rare but fashionable line. And okay, Nils reacted normally, but the white had a pleasant position, and I know Nils tends to get into time troubles sometimes. So I deviated from his preparation very early to let him think. And I basically followed a game Bartel Navara from the Polish League from autumn 2018. And okay, there were some minor differences, but I followed the same plan. I made almost the same moves as Mateusz did. And okay, bishop d1 was also his idea, by the way. We analyzed the game from the Polish League. And okay, it worked better than I had expected, because bishop d1 was designed to protect the knight on f3, among other ideas, and this worked extremely well after bishop f8, bishop f4, knight e5. So Nils probably missed something, and then I got an advantage, but it was not that easy, because I could have transposed into a rook and opposite bishop and game with pawn up, but as black would be able to control the b file, it would probably be close to tenable. So I played differently, but I missed something at one moment. I probably should have played knight e2 instead of rook cb1, because then black could have attacked my f4 pawn by giving a check on h4 and playing g5, I think. So I was sort of lucky, and then it became winning for me, as black's knight was very poorly placed, as well as black's other pieces. And I calculated a way to victory, miscalculated once in it, because I spotted this idea was knight b6 and king d7 only about two moves ahead, which was late, but luckily I had way to victory, c8, knight c5, or knight c5 was not strictly necessary probably, but it was clearly the best, and then it was over.
Interesting. You say lucky, but you make your own luck on the chessboard. Now, you gave some very interesting insight on what happened in the opening. I have to ask you that you were not expecting him to go for Sicilian today, but did you have this idea in your mind that if he did, you will play bishop a4, or did you decide that over the board?
I had this idea, but I had two other ideas as well, so I decided over the board. I was also considering playing something like Wesley Saw did, and I also had one more option.
And one of the big reasons for going into this was that you wanted to play against one of Nils' weaknesses of taking too much time.
I hoped I could exploit this. In fact, he did not play that slowly today, but he missed a pawn somehow. And I mean, I had some practice in this line, and I have analyzed it not so long ago, so I was still able to remember it more or less. And okay, if black reacts adequately, it's fine for him, of course. But it's better than it looks, this bishop a4 move. It looks like a loss of tempo, but in fact, in many lines, the bishop retreats from b5 through d3 to c2, and now I did not need to play bishop d3, so it makes some sense.
I'm sure a lot of people are going to check this lineup. Now tell us, after winning the pawn, David, at any point, did you doubt your advantage or the conversion of it?
I mean, when I played rook E or rook cb1, it was probably not a great move, and then instead of rook b8, black could have given this check on h4, after which he would have got a counterplay. I don't know if it really works, but at least it was undesirable for me.
Coming into this round, what was your approach for today? Were you going to play aggressive and take your chances, or a safety first approach?
I wanted to play for the win because I might play the last two games with black pieces. Hopefully I will not, but it might happen, and it's very hard to win with black pieces on this level. So I wanted to try my luck, and I succeeded.
Today, in fact, we had the sad news that Kramnik announced his retirement. I'm not sure if you knew about this or heard about this before the game. What are your thoughts on this, or how do you feel about that?
Okay, it's his decision. Of course, it will be a loss for chess because he is a great player who has produced plenty of very good games, and it's a pity, but I understand that he was probably disappointed by his latest results, and he has already achieved almost everything in chess. So, okay, it's up to him. I think it's a pity, but new stars will come, and okay, that's how life goes.
Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts. He will definitely be missed by the chess world. All the best for the remaining games.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.